Thank you all. Very good morning to all of you. First of all, would like to thank all of you for being here. I, on behalf of the entire team, would like to thank a few people who've been very supportive in this whole endeavor, the Sports Authority of India and the Government of India for their support over the years, which has helped the players so immensely, the Badminton Association of India, its President Hemanta Biswa Sharma, and the entire team for supporting us, the Indian Olympic Association for their support and help, and very importantly, the fellow coaches and support team, physios, strength and conditioning people, and the entire people who have helped the national camp for this wonderful effort. Overall, this victory is a victory of this team, which has each one of them given their 100% to get this medal. In the last few years, team gold is something which was never dreamt of in a lot of ways. We never imagined that we could win this medal, but I think this is only possible because of the way the entire team played. And I say this with a lot of pride, because many a times it was one or two players who would be the pivots in the team from years, maybe 30 years ago, 40 years, when you look at the history of Indian badminton. But today is different. Today was a day when we had each member of the team, each event in the team contribute to major points, and that was really important. I'll just take you a couple of minutes through this tournament, and I will just ask each of the players to share their words. For me, I think the team championship and the first match of the team championship, the way Ashwini and Satvik played, was the best. I think congratulations, Ashwini and Satvik. I think sometimes in the mix of things, we might actually give the focus to the last match which was won, but actually this was the match which turned the entire tie for us. I think Ashwini's superb game, I think I've said this to her, but I think this is something which was phenomenal. I think hats off to Ashwini for the way she played in the entire tournament. Not easy to play six matches in a day, four matches in a day, and three games, and then continue to play and fight in those entire times, right through the 10 days. I think she's been fantastic. And Satvik also with the doubles and mixed doubles, I think he's been fantastic. The mixed doubles was a great start off, followed by Shrikant's fantastic win against Lee Chong Wei. And also the close doubles match which we lost, where Chirag and Satvik played exceptionally well. I think they're a young combination who've done phenomenally well in the entire tournament. But I think that day, they really played well and lost a close one, and Saina to close off the entire match to make us win the team gold, which I think was the highlight for me especially. For the entire event, I would say whether it was Saina and Sindhu reaching the final, which assured that we got the gold medal, no matter who won, India won the gold medal. I think that was a very important thing for us. To be in a position where two of our players play against each other in the final of a big event like the Commonwealth is something which we feel very proud about, very satisfied about. Apart from these, Shrikant and Pranoy's wins in the men's singles, Shrikant's fantastic silver medal and the close final which he lost to Lee Chong Wei, I think that was something to remember. Pranoy's close loss, I think it hurt a lot for all of us, but I'm sure he'll come back, because on that day he played this long three games against Lee Chong Wei. With a little rest, he had to come back and play against Rajiv Yusuf. That was the tiring, hard match, a sad loss to have, but I'm sure Pranoy, as we call him the beast, he has the willpower and the strength to come back strongly and show what his true potentials are. Satvik and Chirag, that medal I think is very special, men's doubles, first time ever we have reached. I was going through some of the article and all we have is second round, third round, first round. These were the results over the years. To convert that into a fantastic silver medal, I think hats off to both of you. They're very young and I think that's a medal which we'll cherish a lot. Saina and Sindhu, of course, have been very special. They've been a class act over the years. Saina has been fantastic to deliver, and Sindhu has been fantastic to deliver because she beat the reigning Commonwealth champion whom she had lost to last time in Michelle Lee, and it's fantastic to see Sindhu come back strongly to win that match. She had an injury, but it's great that she came back from that injury and pulled out these fantastic wins. And it was a super performance from Sindhu, as always in the big event. And Saina, I think 10 days continuously, I think she shouldered the individual and the team matches. And I think she proved what a champion she is. Congratulations, I think she's been fantastic. She looked fitter, sharper, and I think it's a lot of very good work. And finally, the women's doubles, I think Ashwini and Sikki. As I said, Ashwini has been really the champion for the tournament for me. I think she's played phenomenally well. And Sikki has supported her equally well. I think it was a close match to win the bronze medal, to lose the semi-final. But I think they had their chances and hopefully we'll have another other event where they will convert that into a better medal. But congratulations to both of them. And Pranav and Sikki, I thought they were close to the matches. So we had these two ties where we were fourth in Pranoy and the mixed doubles of Ashwini and Satwik, and a quarterfinals of Sikki and Pranav. I think overall it's been a very, very good performance, very satisfying. And thank you all for the support, blessings. And once again, like to thank Sai, BAI, and my entire team of support, coaches, players, who have been really supportive in this endeavor. Thank you very much. I'll just take this moment to just pass the mic around so each of the players can say their two words, and after that I think we can be open for the press conference. Yeah, Ashwini.
A very good morning to one and all. It's really nice to get back from the Commonwealth Games with team medal. It's the first time we won a medal and it's a historic win for all of us. It was a wonderful memory for me because the best part about the entire Commonwealth Games was the team that I was a part of, starting with Gopi sir, Tan coach, Siadat, Johnson our physio, Kiran the physio, Gayathri our physio, and all my teammates. Everyone's been extremely supportive. It's without whom it would have been quite impossible, because they've been extremely supportive. They made sure that all of us players were taken care of very well before the match, after the match. Our coaches instilled a lot of positivity in us, a lot of confidence in us, and it definitely helped a lot. So I'm extremely happy to be a part of this amazing team, and I'm glad that I have such wonderful teammates who have been behind me. Congratulations to all my teammates for the various medals that they have won as well, because everyone's performed extremely well this tournament. And I only hope that it continues for the other team championships and the other tournaments that we are going to go forward with. So all the best to all of us and hope we do even better. Thank you.
Hello. This is one of the first Commonwealth Games, and like winning a medal in that, like a silver and a gold in the team championship, was truly great. And I would like to thank all the coaches, Gopi sir, Tan coach, and the physios, Kiran sir, Johnson sir, Gayathri, for the continued support. And for me, the highlight would be the mixed team gold, because like India, like as a nation, has never won a gold medal in the team event in badminton, especially. So yeah, that's what I say would be the highlight of the tournament for me. Thank you.
Hi, good morning everyone. I like to thank Gopi sir, Tan coach and physios, Kiran sir, John sir. They helped me a lot. They helped me a lot throughout the tournament, and it was fantastic tournament for everyone. Everyone played really well. Thanks.
Good morning everybody, and definitely a good tournament for all of us, and for the first time we won the mixed team event. And even though I didn't play, I think congratulations to all of us. And coming to the individuals, getting a silver medal. Well, last time I was bronze, so this time a much better one. Hopefully the next time that would be much more better. And apart from that, I would like to thank my coaches, my physios, and the support staff who's been really very supportive all the time. And I hope that we all will do well, and I congratulate each and everybody for getting the medals. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. I think in this tournament, this is the first day after coming back, I got some rest because I've been playing from last 11 days back to back. Yesterday was a journey. But I think I'm blessed to be a part of such wonderful team. For me, especially, it was not the individual which mattered so much, but it was team championship, where I would like to congratulate the doubles players for putting up such big efforts. And I think that's why it was possible for the singles players to come out with such good show as well. So I would like to congratulate Gopi sir and Tan coach for really supporting us very well throughout the team championship. And of course, the physios who have been working day and night with the players there, Johnson sir, Kiran sir, Gayatri, and of course I will like to give my special thanks to Christopher Pedra, who's been behind me for a few weeks now. And I think after his support, this is the first tournament, say after I would say 1.5 years, where I could play 2 weeks without much of complaints and without much of pain. So I'm happy about that, and really, really proud to be of part of this team and winning 2 gold medals, and especially big thanks to Siadat, who helped me with the, I think, a lot of warm up there before the matches. So our other coach Siadat, who really helped us a lot, and yeah, thank you all. Thank you once again.
Good morning, everyone. Well, it's definitely been a great 2 weeks for me. The first week was fantastic. Winning the team event gold for the first time, and it's a huge thanks to all the players, and they've been exceptionally well, and huge thanks to coaches and support team for always helping us. And then right after that, 2 days after that, I became the world number one, and so I can definitely not forget that moment. And then my first individual medal at the Commonwealth Games, I missed out last time, where I couldn't really do well, but this time I'm really happy with the way it went for me. So it's overall, it's been a fantastic 2 weeks, which I can never forget. And I would really, take this opportunity to really thank the coaches, support team, and then the coaches at the academy who've always, who's always been there for all of us. And special mention definitely to the doubles players, who pulled out their first match, Satvik and Ashwini. And they've definitely took out a lot of pressure on me to perform that day. And congrats to both of you. You've done exceptionally well that day. And to the rest of the team, Pranav, for that exceptional start. That was something which gave us a lot of confidence to pull out matches even when we were trailing. So, well, congrats to the whole team, and thank you so much.
Good morning, everyone. Happy to win gold and bronze in my first Commonwealth Games. And I would like to thank all the coaches and support staff from the academy. And these games are really very special for everyone, because it comes once in 4 years, and you can learn a lot from these games, and I can motivate the upcoming players who wants to participate in these games. And I think each and every member of the team are very supportive in these 2 weeks. And I would like to thank Gopi sir, Tan coach, Siadat Bhaiya, Kiran sir, Johnson sir, Gayatri, and all the players also very supportive when we are lost the semi-finals and we have to play for the bronze medal match. I think they are really very supportive, because we need to be mentally very strong to play the bronze medal match. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. I think it's been a special Commonwealth Games for me, the first one, and especially the start with the team event. I felt there was a slight change of attitude from all of us, I would say. And once we got into the quarterfinals, semifinals, I think the way the team was together and the things we were talking was so positive. And I think that was the one reason which actually made the big difference. And I think big credits to the doubles players, because I think the way they were putting in efforts in each matches was just exceptional. And
I think the entire credit goes to the entire players who have done exceptionally well in the team event. And for me, I think Indus was probably a bad day in the office. Two matches and two close matches, and I think a lot of things learned from that one day. But I think probably in the next couple of tournaments, I would be much better. And I think a lot of help from the entire team, Kiran sir, Johnson sir, Gayatri, and all the members of the team, I think was really incredible. And I think it's really important to mention the help from each coaches, each sparring partners, and the physio Sumanj, everyone who has been working incredibly well since last so many years to see us get this gold medal. I think it's such a great journey for all of us. So I hope we keep doing well, and I think the happiness of winning the team event is something special, and I think in the next couple of years we would love to win more of the team championships.
Hi, good morning everyone, and I think it's the same that first I would like to thank all the coaches and all our staff who are there with us, and also who are here, who have been supporting us all around the year, our coaches, our support staff, everyone. Definitely the team gold was something to be proud about, and I think going in as the top seeds, we all believed that we could do that, and each day we gave our best, and in the finals I think it was our doubles which there was so many things going on in the doubles, and then we getting that one point, one start from the doubles, I think, yeah, that was really to be proud about, seeing Ashwini and Satwik pulling off that match, and it was really good to see Chirag and Satwik also play that well, and definitely our singles players have been phenomenal like throughout the year. So I would say, yeah, individuals, I did miss out this time again, I say, and but we would come back and give better performances in the future. Thank you.
One of our other players, Ruthika, is to sit here, but I think she started off our campaign with the mixed doubles with Jerry and Ruthika playing the mixed doubles and then the women's doubles against Pakistan, and also she won her pre-quarter finals against the Singapore in the singles, which was a good win to have. Unfortunately, she had a sprained back injury, and she had to withdraw from the match midway through, but I think it was great that she was around. Unfortunately, she has more pain sitting than standing, so I think she is here as well. So I think what you see here is the real champions sitting, but the team which is worked behind, I think many of them who are sitting there, who are standing there, many of our physios who are sitting there, coaches. We don't have Tan here, Siadat here, he is there, and our three physios who are here, but also all of our Arvin, Sumanj, Swaroop, Rohan, and the entire team which is there, the coaches, Amrish, Dwi, Danu, there are like so many of them who are behind, whom I really want to acknowledge and thank for this wonderful effort here. And yes, there were moments which could have gone better, and in fact that's the beauty of it, because this is our biggest medal haul. But in a way, if I look at it, probably we missed out on two medals at least. So I think it could have been even better, and that's what gives me optimism for the future. I would like to once again congratulate the entire team, and the entire team of Siadat, Tan, Gayatri, Kiran, and Johnson for the wonderful support during this wonderful campaign. Thank you, and you can ask any questions which you want. Thank you. Well, I think as a sport, we might be individual in nature, but there's a lot of benefit which we have for practicing together and working together. And intense rivalries help in bettering each other, because that way you want to better each other, and that becomes raising the bar to the next level. So for me, it's great to have rivalries, it's great to have teams which train together, and we are very fortunate that we are dealing with two girls who are mature, who are handling themselves, and it's great to have this kind of atmosphere in the academy, because that really helps. Having said that, I think each one of us, whether it's Srikanth and Pranoy, or whether it's Ashwini and Sikki as partners, also have a very healthy rivalry. And I think we as coaches, they as players, all of us deal with this in a very healthy and a competitive manner. Well, I think that was the easiest thing to do, because I had no work. So for us, I think the final was the easier one, because on one side we have the coaches, players who have been really working hard, but the fact is also the coaches and the support team had a really tough time, because there was hardly a day's off from the day we went, and they probably, Ashwini had 4 matches, but I had about 11 matches that day. So it was kind of a tough day, and the final was good, because we had rest during that period of time.
Gopi, all these years you had only one individual one, but today it has, stage has come, you have so many medal winners. How excited you are. What started 1-2 medals, today you have plenty of medals. So what is here and what is the next challenge in Asian Games?
Well, I think this is what I dreamt of years ago, but today we've been able to achieve strength in many events and depth in all the events. So there's a lot more work which needs to be done. But also the fact is that we have a group of team of coaches and support team which are really helpful and who are really motivated, because that becomes the entire strength. Because as a person, I don't think I can handle so many. But today, luckily, we have the knowledge and the passion among the rest of the team to ensure that each one of them is actually striving for excellence, and that's what we are looking at today.
Sana, it's a long journey for you. In last Delhi Commonwealth Games, you gave the last gold to India, and this year the same. So how do you feel that this long journey for you had ups and downs, and this is one of the biggest events for your career?
I think it's a very big coincidence. Like, I was the last medalist there as well, and here as well. So I feel proud of that I was someone who will be remembered in the history. And people will know that Saina got the last gold medal in the Commonwealth Games in 2010 and 2018. So, very proud of that. As I said, the challenge was with myself, with my body, to be all right, and I was working on that. And I think throughout the 2 weeks, Gopi sir didn't have any complaint about me playing on the court, and I didn't tell him any kind of issues I had playing the matches. I was really enjoying every match from the day one to the last day. Of course, it gets tiring mentally, as you have to face a lot of challenges in the big events. It's quite difficult. People come out and say, "Kya hua? Udhar kyun nahi mara?" But this tournament is big. Events is always, it comes with a lot of pressure. I think every player goes through that, and I am one of them as well. So I think the match I played in the team championship finals, the problem was more that I have to win for the team. It was not that I'm playing against someone and I have to beat her. It was the challenge against myself, and I didn't want Gopi sir to feel that Saina didn't pull out that crucial match. I didn't want him to feel bad at that moment, and he was really expecting me to finish it there. So that pressure was more than playing that match. So I'm happy that I could pull it out for my team, and finally we are happy to be back with the first mixed team gold medal, and that's what is very special.
You will be having more such Sindhu Saina classes?
Definitely, but the first thing, as I said, I want my body to be all right to play all the big matches, and that's what is important. And I would like to, as I said, give my best in each and every match, and that's what is important. Like I said, this tournament I had no complaints with myself, and I didn't want in the future tournaments as well to have any kind of issues with my injuries or anything. And if I'm playing well, definitely the competition is going to be healthy with Sindhu or the other top players in the world. I wanted to win, that's it. That's my, I go tournaments to win. I don't want to lose to anyone, whether it is Sindhu or anyone. Even she has the same feeling for me, of course. Every player will have it, and it's the final. So everyone wants to win it. But the one thing which I remembered is only that Gopi sir told us before the match, remember that you both are playing for India, and India should feel proud. So that's the only thing which was there in the mind, and definitely winning. No, I don't go with strategies. You can ask Gopi sir also. He said it's worse for you to have any strategy. I'm the only player, I think, who goes without any strategy. And many people say out there that Saina kya strategy lagaya, but I never use any kind of strategy. It is definitely challenging to play with someone who whom you play, like you see every day. That way also I would like to really give a lot of credit to Gopi sir, because he manages our training schedule quite well. He makes sure that we don't have any problems there training together. So we have a different, sparring partners for both of us, and we have the different timing for both of us. So that way is, I think, very, very good for the practice sessions. But it is very challenging to play in the competition with someone whom you know and whom you see every day training with you. I think both of, that's what I said, we see each other every day. So we both know our strong points and weak points, but finally both of us wants to win, right?
So what important. Was most daunting about a Sindhu, and Sindhu, I would like you also to answer the same question. What was most daunting about meeting Sindhu in that final, and to Sindhu the same question again?
I think it was more of, as I said, the challenge was to play, because after, if I lose that match, then the questions, I think you all know what will come out. So there's 100 things saying that, अरे फिर हार गई कुछ इशू था इंजरी था ये था वो था तो आई डोंट वांट टू आंसर ऑल दैट आई जस्ट वांटेड टू आंसर यार मैं जीत गई बस एंड दैट वाज द ओनली थिंग आई वाज प्रिपेयर्ड ऑफ एंड रेस्ट आई थिंक पीपल एंजॉयड द मैच इट वाज अ वेरी इंटेंस मैच इट वाज क्वाइट आई थिंक 64-65 शॉट्स रैली वाज देयर इन दैट सेकंड गेम सो आई एम हैप्पी दैट आई कुड प्ले सच अ लॉन्ग रैली वेयर आई डिडंट वांट टू एक्चुअली go for any more attack as I was finished. I just wanted to do lot more rallies, and I'm happy that I could do it in the last few points, which was very crucial. So yeah,
Sindhu.
Well, definitely yes, it was an intense match, and I think two Indians playing there, a proud moment, yes. But as Gopi sir said, that you need to play for the country, and on court, yes, the rivalry is obviously there, but once the match is over, remember that we are playing for the country. And apart from that, definitely we will go there to win on court. Well, about Saina, even she would think the same way, and me playing against her, even I would think the same way. But I think definitely only one can win in the final. So it's been a good match, and I think it was hurting.
Sindhu, yes, yes. Come so close in so many matches, big tournaments. You're not able to cross the one. How do you feel that? How do you next time going to cross that? This is something.
I think very important is that giving your best is very important, mainly. And I think winning and losing is secondary. But I think you have to just give your best. And I know there were many matches where I've actually come close and I've been losing. But definitely, I think I have to work on that and come back much more stronger.
Did you search for the Gopi, both of you, when you were playing singles matches, because you used to come and sit on the sidelines? So how's the feeling there? No coach to take advice?
We know obviously before the match he's not going to sit for anybody, so we didn't actually search for him. And I thought that he would not see our match, but I don't know whether he saw the match or not.
You didn't ask him?
No, we haven't asked.
So what were you doing, Gopi, at that time? Watching the match?
No, I actually, we were like, I came in, I think I and Johnson went out to see the, physio Johnson and me went out to see the running track there outside. And we came back at around 17th point and I, Kiran and Johnson watched it on the television there for the last 5 points because the next match was Srikanth and that was the only interest there. But really, as both of them really fought well, I will watch the match, of course, later, maybe for academic purposes. But for me, I think the fact that they fought really well, there was a very intense match, that's what I heard the players say. And I think just to find out who made what weaknesses, I'll watch it. But for me, I think at the end of the day, whoever win, one, we are assured of a gold. And that feeling is very nice because the day before, you at least can count one gold, one silver in the bag, no matter what the result is. So I was just hoping that I could have that feeling in the men's singles as well. And that day would have been really great. But it doesn't turn out that way yet. But I'm sure in the years to come, we will have this happen more often.
Yeah, this is for Ashwin.
So there was one funny incident as well. When I finished my match with Christine, and I was talking to Kashyap, I was like, yaar, bahut thak gaya, aaj teen game ho gaya, aaj to mar gayi. I think it's been very tough for last 10 days. Because Sindhu ke saath, it's going to be All Indian final, and people will be there ready that Saina kuch ho jaye to aisa fir tire ho jaye, kuch to bhi puch lenge. Then I asked him, kya karna hai, yaar, kaise ho raha hai? It was like, and I told him, I don't want to lose. You know, I don't want to lose, I want to give my best. You know, that was my feeling. So he was like, or better option bhi ho sakta hai. You know, there can be something that you can fight in that support also when you have your friends out there. My father was there when I asked him the same thing. Bahut dard ho raha hai, so even in fact, when I went to the massage there, they were like, I've not seen such tired body in the whole tournament for other players. So I was like, let us see, let us hope for the best. So these people were around there and they were talking to me continuously saying that just give your best and we definitely believe that you can pull out the match. We know how tiring it is when you play such a big event with so much of pressure and in 12 days maybe I've hardly slept. I'm sure Gopi sir won't like it. He was there saying that 9:30 sab so jana chahiye, sab logo ka phone switch off ho jana chahiye. So I was worried about that ke after the finals, he should not come and say, you were awake till 10:30 and that's why I think you couldn't focus on the match. So all the things were, these things really matter a lot when you play such big events. And everything turned out in the favor, so I'm very, very happy about it. And I would like to thank, of course, Kashyap, Papa and Gopi sir for being there and supporting every moment and making me feel that, yes, it's a tough tournament, but you have to be alert and there's always a better option that you can fight it out and win it. So these things really motivate you.
Hi, this is for Ashwini. Yeah. Having played 4 matches in a single day, how tiring mentally and physically for you? How did you cope with it?
Well, to be honest, going into the semi-final match, I never really expected that I would have to play 4 matches on the same day because I was gunning to win both our matches, Sikki and I winning our women's doubles and Sathvik and me winning the mixed doubles. I was really gunning for us to win those matches. I was quite disappointed with the first match that we lost our women's doubles, so it was a hard blow for me. And then getting onto the court again for the mixed doubles and losing that again was quite hard because that's when I realized that I had 2 more matches and that the day wasn't over and that the bronze medal match would be the same day. But thankfully, with the support of Gopi sir and the words that he told me, it really motivated me a lot to get back onto court because he ensured that at the end of the day, winning a medal is a medal. It could be the bronze, but it's still a medal at the end of the day and to fight for that. And of course, the coaches and the physios, Johnson has helped me tirelessly. He's been there at the stadium from morning till evening, making sure that my body was okay, I was relaxed. Kiran and Gayatri, all of them have been really supportive. And of course, both my partners, Sikki and Sathvik, they had a huge task ahead of them, knowing that I was already playing 2 matches. We had played 2 matches, plus I had 2 more matches, so their support definitely helped a lot because when we get onto the court as doubles players, we do rely a lot on our partners. And both Sikki and Satwik took on a huge task of supporting me and ensuring that they were there by my side, and that definitely helped. I'm extremely happy that Sikki and I won the women's doubles. I really wish I could have given it a little more with the mixed doubles, because Satwik was taking on a lot on his shoulder. He was fighting it out. I wish I could have supported him a little more. I'm sure we would have won that match. But all in all, I'm happy that I had great support and a great team who helped me to get through that day.
And Satwik and Chirag, this is your first tournament and you won India's first ever men's doubles medal. So when you won semifinals and you were assured of a medal, what was your reactions?
I think we are pretty confident that we can win a medal for India. So we prepared really well before we were going. So we are pretty confident that we can win in the finals also, but we are in under pressure to play in the finals. So it's our first big event. So we are really under pressure. We couldn't get the rhythm and we couldn't give our best. So yeah.
Getting into the final and we were the first Indian pair to play a final. So obviously we had a lot of pressure getting into the final. But in the second game, the first game we couldn't get our rhythm, and in the second game, after 11 we started playing well. So if we would have started a bit more earlier, like if we had a good start in the game, I think we could have beaten them, because if we had played against them in a semi-final or a quarter-final, I would say we would have defeated them. But I think the finals pressure caught up upon us, and a bit disappointed, but happy with the medal, silver medal.
Oh, Srikanth, just so close, and you got the world number one, then you had to play Lee Chong Wei, who had 35, showed some good strokes. How was the game actually in the finals?
Well, I think it was a tough one. No, I actually played well in the first set, and then maybe until the first half of second set I was there with him. But I couldn't really play at my best during that second half of second game and the start of third set. I think the third set was really bad. I gave him too much lead in the beginning, and I should have definitely avoided it. But otherwise, I'm very happy with the way I played throughout the tournament. Like, again, playing for 10 continuous days is always tough. I didn't want to say this, but still, I know he's very angry, if I say this, but still, again, I should have done a little better at the start of third game. But he definitely has the experience to pull out those close matches and the tough ones. I don't really want to repeat this again when I play him next time.
Srikanth. Okay.
Well, it'll definitely be a bigger challenge. Reaching there is just one side of the coin. To be able to maintain, to be able to be there for a long time is the ultimate challenge for me. And for that, I really need to be consistent. I really need to work hard and then play consistently well in the next tournaments I play.
So getting to the top, being number one, is it just a number? Or is it a very well-cherished dream, much-cherished dream? And you bettered your guru. So does the guru feel happy about the pupil having surpassed him in terms of rankings?
I remember when Saina was 5, I would say you have to get one more to be better than me. And I think I told Srikanth also the same when he was 6 and 5. I've been 4, so you better get better than me. I think, to be honest, they've far bettered what I've done years ago. And
you didn't have a gopi.
But well, today, I think for us, we are looking at a different era, and the benchmarks have to be different. Gopi cannot be the benchmark for them. And I think for them to play many, many years and to stay there long and to win many, many tournaments is something which is important. Because as a team, whether it's Commonwealth Games, whether it's Asian Games, whether it's Thomas Huber Cups, whether it's the Super Series events. I think they've been all first times ever which we've achieved consistently well. So I think the benchmark now should be to be better than China, better than Japan, better than Indonesia, Malaysia, and that's what our target should be. And we are there. There's a lot of work which needs to be done. As a system, we are far from there. I think for us now, the benchmarks are higher, the targets are higher, and every time we go, our responsibilities are also higher because we are defending something. So the next time we go into the Commonwealth Games, we go in with these as a defending champion. So I think our responsibilities are also different. So I think we need to have new strategies to ensure that we climb higher, and they're all young, they're experienced, they'll be there for a long period of time. So I do expect them to shoulder a lot more responsibility and also groom a lot more players who will take the responsibility. So we are looking at a different era. It's great to be here, but the possibilities which these players have shown at this tournament makes us very optimistic of the future for Indian badminton.
Hi, my question.
Number one being a number or something that you're looking forward to, and does it add more pressure or took off some pressure?
Well, first of all, it's a number, but then everyone dreams of it. Like, to be there on top of the world is definitely a special feeling. Not many, you know, have achieved this, you know, in the men's singles. I think I've read an article where I think I've become only the sixth men's singles player from 2009 to be crowned world number one. So, but again, at the same time, I'm not really thinking only about rankings. I really want to consistently perform well, and if I can really continue doing well, you know, the rankings will definitely stay. You know, I don't really have to run behind the rankings.
Sorry, can you repeat? Not really. Like I would say, we had 2 week training session, like training before the Commonwealth Games. Like, we came directly from All England, and after that we had 2 week sessions. So yeah, like there was nothing different leading up to the Commonwealth Games. It was just the usual stuff, like normal training, and nothing special. But yeah, obviously the intensity was much higher because, like, we are getting into the Commonwealth Games, and it's for us, it was one of the biggest events we've ever played. So yeah, the intensity was much higher in the sessions.
Yeah, I think we are really prepared for the new service rule before while going. So, and when we reached there, we got to know there was a old service rule. So we are a bit confident about that, and we gave our best and we played really well.
I think from 2010 up until now, as a nation, we've grown a lot in terms of badminton. We have a lot more players, and the medals speak volumes, because we've won way more medals this time, and a lot of firsts. So we've come a long way, and it's just the beginning. We have an even longer way to go, and I'm pretty sure that as a nation, we're going to do even better in badminton with more players coming up and bettering what we've also done.
Challenge for me? Pressure for all the players every time we play. So it's not like senior or junior. Mujhe bhi utna pressure tha. Even Satvik had the same kind of pressure and Chirag had the same kind of pressure. So it's not about if suppose some 13-year-old is playing, so he'll play with less pressure. Everyone will have the same kind of pressure because the expectations are there that you are few of them who are going for the country to play there, and you have to give your best. You have to come back with medals and you have to give your best. That is important. So it's not about that. You always have to think you're going there to just win it. It's important that you give your best. If I don't play well, how will I win it? So it's important that you work hard, you do your training properly, you correct yourself in whichever way like you feel that you're weak at. Of course, coaches are there to work on that, physios are there, trainers are there to do your you know, to help you out in that way. But on the court, it's important if you've worked hard, the performance will definitely it will be good. So that's why I think the results this time, if you see in doubles, because they have worked hard, they were not worried about picking up those difficult shots, which I never thought that they can pick up. You know, when I was watching actually Satvik and Ashwini playing against the Malaysian pair, I was like, ye bhi utha liya, wo bhi le liya. I mean, it is just because they have worked hard. They know that if we play at that level and we have to win medal at that level, it's important that we work like them. Rest, I think we should not think about at that moment that we have to get back with the medal. It's definitely not right because it's not going to help you out in any way. You have to give your best, but you have to keep in your mind some way that it's going to be very good that if you win it. Next time you have to just keep yourself positive, that keep working on it, and definitely you'll come out with good results. So there should never be a kind of feeling that when you go from here to any tournament saying that ki jeetna hi hai. It's definitely not right, I feel, as a player. So
sir, this question is to Gopi sir. How do you see India's performance overall? How is India doing at the international level?
Well, as I think overall this has been a great performance. Year on year for the last few years, if you look at our performances, have gone better. This has been a time where the last Commonwealth, we had Kashyap and Guru win the men's singles gold and bronze after 32 years. And then now we have a final between both our players. First medal in our men's doubles. Ladies doubles had a medal. We had a mixed team gold for the first time. Apart from Malaysia and England, no other team had won the mixed gold. So I think every year has been better, and this year for us has been great for the Commonwealth Games. I think overall it was fantastic. I think to India to win, because last time I think we had won 15 medals and this time there's much more than that. Of course, we were a little short of what was the medals tally in Delhi. But having said that, I think the medals tally in Delhi was from a few players who got multiple medals, whether it was, I think, Jaspal Rana and Gagan, and many of them won 5, 5, 6, 6 medals, and that was the bulk of the medals were won by 4 or 5 players. But this time, I think everybody contributed. You had badminton, you had TT, you had squash, you had athletics, and we had, of course, shooting, wrestling and boxing, the big medals. But these were really big medals from multiple people who have come. So this changed the dynamics for sport. and you look really like a multi-sport event country for us, and that's a huge change from what has been happening in the past. I think if you're okay, I think we've answered a lot. Thank you very much. Lunch is being served upstairs. I would request all of you to please don't ask for one-on-one interviews. I think that will be a long time. If that is there, then we can close.
No, go.
One picture. Okay.